Good afternoon, America, and welcome once again to Business Credit Radio. We're on blogtalkradio.com. As everybody knows, Business Credit Radio is the voice for credit and financial professionals worldwide. Today, our sponsor is our good friends at CMA.
This evening's show is partially brought to you by the Credit Management Association, a proud affiliate of the National Association of Credit Management that has helped business-to-business companies with their credit, collections, and financial decisions since 1883. Contact CMA at www.creditmanagementassociation.org for more details on how CMA can benefit you. This segment of Business Credit Radio is brought to you by the Law Offices of Robert S. Bernstein, Managing Partner of Bernstein Berkeley PC, bringing a business approach to legal service. Call 412-456-8113 for more details.
Thank you. My name is Philip Philbin, and I am the host for Business Credit Radio tonight. This afternoon's co-host is Mr. Rick Balgobin from the Mile High City in Denver, Colorado. Say hello, Rick.
Hello, Phil. Hello, Anita. And good day to everyone, and welcome to our show.
Thank you very much. We're looking forward to a great show today. Before we get started, I want to talk to our potential callers. Callers, when you want to call in, you want to talk to Aneta, and you want to talk to me, dial in to 347-989-8342. Now, once again, that's 347-989-8342. Now, what happens is, when you dial in, your phone number appears on my studio. I call you out by your area code number, and then you're free to ask your questions of Aneta or myself or Rick, and we'll be happy to answer your questions. And we appreciate our entire audience coming to us from all over the world, our peers and friends in the credit and finance management industry. Thank you for joining us again today. Today on Business Credit Radio, we are honored to welcome Aneta Spilman, who is the president and COO of ICTF, which is the Association of International Credit and Trade Finance Professionals. Aneta Spilman, CAE, which stands for Certified Association Executive, is the president of ICTF, the Association of International Credit Trade Finance Professionals, launched in 2010 by former board members of SCIB-NACM. Prior to taking the helm at ICTF, Aneta served as the president of SCIB. She started her career in international business credit at Euler Hermes, ACI, back in 1996. As an export credit insurance analyst and underwriter, Aneta holds a master's degree in international business from University of Baltimore. Her international background, business experience, leadership, passion, and integrity have been instrumental in positioning ICTF as the leading international credit management association worldwide. Today's discussion, we're going to discover what ICTF is all about, and we welcome Aneta to help us do that. Hello, Aneta.
Hello, Phil, and thank you so much for this opportunity. Thank you for the invitation to Business Credit Radio Show, and thank you again for the opportunity to share our remarkable success story.
We're honored to have you, Aneta. We're looking forward to it. I know Rick and I have been looking forward to it all week long. We're going to first start off by talking about when you first launched ICTF. When was that? How did the whole thing happen?
Yes, I'll be happy to share this with you and the audience. ICTF was launched in September 2010, only 3 short years ago. And as we celebrate its third anniversary, I'm beyond excited about how far we've come. Because that, like I said, it was only 3 years ago when the former board members of FCIB and ACM made the visionary decision to build an independent, not-for-profit, member-led, first-class association which stands shoulders above the rest, and which exists and operates for the benefits of its members. And this is what we undertook to do 3 years ago, and this is where we are. Members are the focus of ICTF. All of the profits of the association are kept in the ICTF members' coffers. And it's a fabulous membership, a member-run association, which has become the number one association in international credit management in 3 short years.
Yeah, I saw your post on LinkedIn, and of course it immediately your name. I mean, you and I have known each other for years through the FCIB, so immediately I had to call you and jump on and get you to come on to the show. And you have such a great website. Why don't you tell people where your website is so they can check it out?
Yes, I will be happy to do that and talk a little bit about the benefits of membership, what ICTF is all about, how we help the international business community and the international credit management professionals. First, as far as the website, please take a look and see what's available. It is www.ictfworld.org. It's not .com, it's .org because it's a not-for-profit, ictfworld.org. It's a great website with a tremendous amount of resources which are available to members and non-members, while members have the advantage of being part of this vast network of international credit professionals, and while there are specific member resources which are not available to everyone. As a not-for-profit, as a true professional association, we're here to help, and I have never turned a non-member away. Anyone who is out there, who is struggling, or who needs additional information, who needs a resource to do his or her job better, to advance his or her career, is more than welcome to contact us and to seek out our expertise. And talking about the expertise, it's the connections that we have. It's the combined, the collective knowledge of the members who are part of ICTF, of this great association. They're the ones who have the expertise, the knowledge, the passion, and the experience to help you and to help us. And that cannot be replicated. Speaking of which, I also would like to share with you where we are today in 3 short years. I'm so pleased that today, well over 650 members call ICTF their association, and it is their association of choice, and it is that for a reason. Certainly, as the president of the association, I'm perhaps biased, and it is my passion and my dedication, but this is the feedback we're getting from the international business community. This is the feed. This is what members and non-members are telling us. It's a great organization. Keep doing what you're doing. Keep working and improving and elevating the status of the international credit management profession and the professionals who are involved with it, which takes me to the ICTF mission, which is very simple. It is to advance the profession of international credit management. We do that by providing unmatched expertise, leadership, powerful connections, and leading-edge educational programs and services, creating an unparalleled forum for the exchange of information and the exchange of best practices, thus helping domestic and international credit professionals to succeed. So like I said, it's very simple, but at the same time, it involves a lot of work, a lot of dedication, and a lot of expertise to make things happen and to be able to provide these resources and business intelligence to you, both the corporates and vendors, and to help you do your job better. Our goal as an association, as a first-class association, is, of course, to attract the brightest minds, the top talent, professionals who truly demonstrate a commitment to excellence, commitment to improve performance. And for us, it is so important, and we have already done it, building a reputable, the most reputable, world-class international credit and trade finance membership organization. And an organization which truly values, respects, and protects the interests and the assets of its members. And we're very, very proud and very happy to have been able to do that. The future is in front of us. There's so much more that we would like to do and undertake. And it is the vision of our leaders, our board of directors. Feel free to take a look on the website and see who these professionals are. But like I said, they're top-notch international credit management professionals who have the passion, the vision, and the dedication, and who know what they want and who know how to represent the interests of the members of ICTF and to expand the global scope and the reach of the association, not just by increasing the number of members, but also by enhancing the resources which are available by adding more resources. And I will share some of this with you and answer any questions you might have. But we're constantly thinking, keeping our fingers on the pulse, brainstorming, trying to figure, talking to members, asking for their input and feedback so we can figure out what's next, where do we go from here, how do we provide more and even better, if there's such thing. An example of that, last week, we launched a new series of webinars and online education insolvency from the international credit manager's perspective, from the trade creditor's perspective. The very first educational webcast was specifically on insolvency issues and the compare and contrast thing in the NAFTA region, Canada, U.S., and Mexico. It went extremely well, and there are many educational offerings out there. No one has quite done this particular one, and this is a series which we're launching. The first one was U.S., Canada, and Mexico. It will be followed by quite a few more, which are being lined up as we speak. We will be comparing and contrasting insolvency laws and issues, trade creditors' issues specifically, in UK, Germany, other Western European countries. Then we will move to the Mediterranean countries. We will move to the Middle East, to Asia. So very soon you will be able to to not just participate in these webinars, whether live or later on digital replays, but you will have a pretty good, trade creditors will have a pretty good grasp of what's going on and what they should be aware of in terms of insolvency tricks and insolvency intricacies in various countries around the world. And the best part is not just the webinar, but the ebook which comes with it. The first one will be released next week, and it is based on the webinar which we had. A number of questions, the most important questions for trade creditors, which have been answered by very experienced and knowledgeable law professionals from these markets. So you will shortly see the ebook on insolvency laws for trade creditors in U.S., Canada, and Mexico. It is certainly going to be available for free to our members. Non-members will have the opportunity, of course, to join the association and take advantage of all of these resources. It's a 60-plus page book, a tremendous reference guide for trade creditors. Just one example of what's available and how we're trying to be innovative and bring new things and new education to the international credit management professional. That was just one short example. I would like to talk to you also, to share with you, if hopefully you're interested, the benefits of membership. And like I said, this is not a money-making machine. We are not a commercial entity per se. We are a not-for-profit member-led association. Yes, we do have to charge membership fees, and we do have to charge registration fees for conferences, for symposiums, for educational offerings to be able to not only sustain the operation but grow the operation and provide something bigger and better for the international credit manager out there. I'm so excited that we were able to reconnect with Phil because his offerings are also great, and just this idea of a business credit radio that is just spectacular, and no one has thought of that before. So kudos to Phil and his team for bringing that and for launching such a business credit radio and making it the voice of credit and trade finance professionals worldwide. So that is fabulous. Talking about benefits of ICTF membership, I can probably talk all day, but I will try to summarize them and make it presented in a very concise manner. And, of course, if you have any questions, if you would like to learn more about any specific benefit or resource which is available, I'm always here to serve you, and so is the ICTF staff. By the way, before I start talking about the benefits of membership, keep in mind that we have an operation in the U.S. We also have an operation in Europe, in the U.K., which allows us to better serve our European members and to be close to them, the members to serve the European as well as a few members that we have from the Middle East. And everyone else is served from the U.S. office, members.
Let me jump in here. I got a question for you.
Yes, already. Go ahead.
You accomplished this all in 3 years? An office in Europe. You got an office going here. How many different symposiums and various meetings have you had since you're... This is impressive. What do you think, Rick?
Thank you.
Very, very impressed in it, and that was one of my main questions. In 3 years' time, you have certainly come a very, very long way. And I kudos to you for being able to launch this program and have it where everybody can get a good education and become a member of a fabulous team.
Well, thank you very much for that. Yes, it is hard work, but we're so passionate about it. And it's not just the staff, it's also the board members. These are volunteers who had the vision, who were determined to launch and build a not-for-profit, independent, member-led association. And we did it. I'm humbled, but it is just an incredible opportunity for everyone. It's been the most wonderful, challenging, but rewarding at the same time journey. And speaking about the conferences, yes, we do have two conferences each year, two major conferences in the U.S. and two major conferences in Europe. That has been the case ever since we launched in September 2010. So do the math, four major conferences in Europe. And I will share with everyone the one which is coming up, because October and November is perhaps the busiest season for us. I'm heading to Basel, Switzerland next week for our European symposium, the ICTF International Credit Symposium in Switzerland, and coming back, heading to Florida in several short weeks for the ICTF Annual Global Trade Symposium, which will be held November 10th through the 12th in Palm Beach, Florida. If you want me, I will be happy to share some of the highlights of the program. But the one thing which is very impressive and we're so proud of is that the ICTF symposiums have become the largest gatherings of international credit professionals in the U.S. We attracted a little over 160 delegates last year in Florida, and we're looking at similar numbers this year, which, again, perhaps it's not 1,000, but we don't want to have 1,000 people in the room. That completely changes the dynamics and the quality and everything else. We are talking about a think tank, about a small, relatively large and small, but very experienced group of international credit professionals, and not just experienced. We welcome the novices as well, because there's so much to learn just by listening to the speakers, by networking, by exchanging best practices, sharing your concerns, your questions, getting your questions answered. The camaraderie, the exchange of best practices, the networking is tremendous. It's just outstanding, and these are, again, not my words. I'm very passionate about it, and I want to do the best for the community. But this is what those who are attending are saying, and those who cannot attend always look forward to the next one so they can get involved and they can be part of this.
Yeah, I want to talk to you a little bit more about that after we do our commercial break here. I want to talk more about what is the general attraction that you've heard from people. I'd like to hear what they're saying about the ICTF and why are they so attracted to the organization. Stay tuned, fans. We've got Aneta Spilman from the ICTF here with us today, and we're going to take a quick commercial break. Please stay tuned.
Bill Philbin here for Business Credit Radio. Advertisers, what do you say we give the phrase, in this economy, a rest? What does that mean anyway? That maybe in this economy, you've got a great deal for customers, but in the next economy, no soap? Maybe you should take a cue from Business Cutter Radio. We help people save money in any economy with the lowest price for any national radio commercial ad. Something you should think about in this... Oops. I'm Phil Philbin for Business Cutter Radio, and we'll leave the phone lines open for you. Contact us at ccma-llc.com. This portion of Business Cutter Radio is brought to you by ICTF, the number one International Credit Management Association. You are invited to attend the ICTF Annual Global Trade Symposium on November 10th through November 12th in Palm Beach, Florida. To check the agenda and superb lineup of speakers, visit ICTF's website, www.ictfworld.org, or contact ICTF at info@ictfworld.org. This segment of Business Cutter Radio is brought to you by Gene Tengway and Credit Scoring Services. Call Gene at 650-279-6843 for more details.
Thank you, thank you. We're back live with Aneta Spilman from ICTF and my good friend, Mr. Rick Balgaman from the Mile High City in Denver, Colorado. We were talking about ICTF and the benefits of joining and what the crowd is saying out there about ICTF and why is there so much of an interest in joining. Help us with that, Aneta. What's it all about?
Yes, I can answer perhaps part of the question. Sometimes I pinch myself at the just seeing the interest that is out there, and we want to keep it this way. I think what distinguishes ICTF is the degree of professionalism and also our ability to bring together some of the most sophisticated international credit professionals. And that by itself, as one member and conference delegate put it, creates an extraordinary environment to share and to learn the latest international best practices and to be among the best and to be part of this. I think what's very attractive to people is that this is an independent association, that it is truly member-led. There are no shareholders. There are no parents. Everything that we do is done for the benefits of the members. So what I see is members feel part of it. They feel the ownership. So everyone would like to make it work, and they would like to be part of the best. And that's what we strive to achieve, and that's what we have been doing. Again, it sounds like a simple formula, and it's working. But to me, what makes a huge difference in any trade association is the people who are involved with it, just like with most businesses. Their willingness to work, their willingness to roll up their sleeves and to help each other, the camaraderie, the friendships which are formed, the professional friendships, and wanting to help each other, wanting to advance the profession of international credit management.
Well, Rick and I are no strangers to being involved with organizations that exchange information and make the business work for us. Rick, mm-hmm. Do you have any comments on the ICTF and the international credit collection area?
I'm looking at the website now. It is most fascinating. And one of the things I was looking at is what I've been a credit manager for the last 20-something plus years, I would like to know how do I go about, if I'm not affiliated to any companies or association, to become part of your organization?
Mm-hmm. We do accept individual memberships as well as corporate memberships. Most of our members, most of the memberships are corporate memberships, where you can take advantage of multiple people getting involved with ICTF for the same fee, but there are there is the individual membership type, which is available. It's $595 a year, which on the grand scheme of things, it's not a huge investment at all. When you look at the vast network and the doors which are open in front of everyone and the ability, even if you cannot attend a symposium because of budget perhaps or time constraints or whatnot, there are so many resources online and just the ability to pick up the phone and call a fellow member, call us and have your questions answered, or provide, not just have your questions answered, but provide your expertise for the benefit of the rest of the membership community. We like members who are involved, who are truly involved. They not just take, they give and they take. Everyone contributes and everyone reaps the benefits of that. That's what the community is all about, and that's, to me, what's the most successful model of a successful association.
I hate to ask this question, but it's in the back of my mind. There are other organizations out there who their philosophy is almost on the same guidelines like you. How do you compare yourself to these other organizations that most companies we have worked with, this name always comes across? You have to go to their courses. You have to become a member of this. And so how do we compare you to them?
Frankly, on the international side, there are not many associations out there, and there is nothing that compares to ICTF. And again, that's why we have been able to attract over 650 members in such a short period of time. And we welcome everyone to compare our offerings. So we welcome competition. But as far as education is concerned, ICTF has set the bar. We have partnered with the Thunderbird School of Global Management 2 years ago, and as probably many of the people in the audience, most of them know that Thunderbird School of Global Management is rated number one worldwide as far as international business education is concerned, so there is no comparison in the offerings. We partnered with them 2 years ago to develop the most advanced educational courses in international credit and trade finance, and that's how we launched the Essentials in Advanced International Credit and Trade Finance online courses, which have been very successful and very well received. And again, there are people who have taken other courses in the past and who have chosen to enroll in the ICTF Thunderbird classes as well, and they're the ones who come back and say, wow, this is incredible. I've never seen something like it. The depth of knowledge, the breadth of topics which are included in the course, and also the instructors who are involved with the courses makes a huge difference. These two educational offerings I would like to mention for everyone out there, anyone who is interested, just so you know, they lead to two professional designations. The Essentials class leads to the Registered Global Credit Professional designation, and then we have the next step, which is the Advanced class, the Advanced International Credit and Trade Finance course, which leads to the Certified Global Credit Executive designation. And if you go out there and look at other offerings and compare, keep in mind, and this is a fact, that Certified Global Credit Executive is the only executive level designation in the marketplace, which is supported by a very rigorous program of study. We don't give designations. We really require people to acquire the knowledge, and even if they're very experienced, they still would want to take the classes because it's so multifaceted and there's so much to learn. And as you well know from your experience, various organizations put emphasis on different things. So not everyone is dealing with every single aspect of credit management. So these courses become very comprehensive, a very comprehensive body of knowledge, which adds tremendous value. And, again, not only do you learn, not only do you enhance your knowledge and your skill set, you also receive the designation, which is becoming more and more recognized in the marketplace. And the tie with the Thunderbird School of Global Management is just an added bonus and something that you cannot get from anywhere else. Hence, hopefully this answers your question and the question that many others in the many others in the audience might have.
Let me jump real quick, Aneta. I want to remind everybody where they can go to get this information, as long as we're still talking about it. That's www.ictfworld.org. One more time, That's www.ictfworld.org. And they'll be more than happy to help you with any questions that you may have. One question that I have, and one of the bullet points on your website, is just draws me right there. We're talking about resources. Tell me about the resources for members or people who want to become members. What is available for them? How can that help them?
Yes, sure. I will be glad to summarize. I think we were going in that direction at one in the beginning, and then there's so much to talk about, and it's all so exciting. To summarize it, perhaps, and I hope I don't miss anything here, educational and networking events, we already touched on that. They're leading edge, no question about it. And just take a look at the upcoming ones, the annual Global Trade Symposium, and look at the speakers and the topics. We can talk about that a little more. These symposiums are absolutely incredible. The online offerings, webinars, most of our webinars are free to members. Non-members pay a fee, but we manage through sponsorships. We manage to provide them as a membership benefit without charging members for most of them. There are perhaps a couple where we have to charge, but here, prime example, the insolvency one, which we did last week, and that was a two-day webinar since there was so much to talk about. It's 100% free for members, and non-members are charged $195. So when you start looking at value for membership, the value of the membership dollar, it's a very simple proposition and very easy to even get it approved by your boss, the membership fee, if you need approval. The online courses, which I just mentioned, excellent educational offering, the professional designations, networking, that's somewhat intangible, but not to be forgotten, and it's very important these days. So you know that I'm preaching to the choir here, but being able to establish relationships with such experienced and knowledgeable international credit peers, being able to draw from this peer-driven insight, there is no substitute for that. Additionally, I have to mention the online member forum and resource center, which is available to members. There are tons of articles, all very relevant and real-time business intelligence that members can tap into, a number of white papers, semi-annual and on-demand benchmarking surveys. This is something that we do and members find extremely useful. One of the surveys, like the signature ICTF survey, is the semi-annual global payments benchmarking surveys, where we ask members to share with us their most recent experience on every single market out there, how many markets, how many countries they do business in, are payments deteriorating, is there a change, are they perhaps improving, or is it status quo, what payment terms are they offering. It's all blind. We have to make sure we comply with all laws, rules and regulations, but we can find out what are the predominant payment terms in a particular market. Nothing is customer specific, it's more of country specific. Very valuable information, so people can benchmark themselves and see where they are and how they're performing, what percentage of your portfolio is past due, which areas of the world are the most challenging for you, and we dig deeper into that. We don't look only at the quantitative part of it, but we go into the qualitative part as well. For the challenging markets, we want to know what your challenges are and what are you doing about it. So again, tremendous amount of life experience that members share among each other. And other on-demand benchmarking surveys. If a member has a need, and I'll give you just one example, recent example from a survey, the on-demand survey which we conducted, we are there, we jump right on it to help our members. Like I said, they're the focus, they're the number one priority. Everything we do is for the members. We had a member, and actually it became a very interesting thing because it turned out quite a few others were interested in that topic, the shared services in China and the challenges associated with it. So we put together a survey of 10 questions, which went out, and turned out, like I said, that there were quite a few people who have that on their plate or on their mind, and who were able to provide quite a bit of input on that particular topic, and quite a few others, which we have done. So that's, again, something very unique, that it's an on-demand, based on your specific needs, you as the center of attention, and everyone else providing input and helping you. But by doing that, we're helping the whole community, and we're helping the membership. Global Business Intelligence and Publications is another very important membership benefit. That includes weekly country updates, which are sent out every Friday. It's sent out not just to members, to non-members as well, but non-members cannot read. All they see is the headlines. So, because, again, we have to make sure that we're doing what we need to do for the members. They're paying a membership fee, so we've got to be fair as much as we would like to help everyone and as much as we do help everyone. But these weekly country updates are extremely valuable. They're done. We have our, probably many of you know, Dr. Hans Belchak from S.J. Runs & Associates. He's one of our founding members, and he is one of the best, if not the best, country analysts out there. And his country analysis is from a trade creditor's perspective as well, which makes a big difference. We don't talk just macroeconomic stuff. We talk about practical trade credit-related issues. So the country updates are very important because, as you know, everyone is so busy. Everyone is pressed for time. You can, as an international credit professional, we have to make your job easier, and that's our goal and our mission, too, not just to elevate the status of the profession. You can only monitor so many newspapers and internet sites, and there's pretty much, I would say, an overload, as we all know, an overload of information. So we do the work for you. We help with that, and we send those short and concise country updates, bringing to your attention the volatile markets, the volatile areas, and giving you a heads up, plus additional in-depth articles and market research, industry research, which we have come across and which we work very hard on obtaining from our sponsors, from other organizations, and from people who are doing that for a living and to make it available to members. We do have a quarterly magazine as well. It's a digital magazine. Everyone is going digital these days. It is published in association with CCR World, which is a European publication house. Again, very valuable information. Monthly newsletters which go out to the members, they're not promotional materials. They are, well, of course, they tell you everything that's happening, the latest and greatest as far as ICTF is concerned, but also provide quite a few valuable articles and resources. So in those newsletters. We do provide international credit reports, country reports, and country intelligence. There is a cost associated with that. Certainly members are taking advantage of a 20% membership discount. And the good part about it's not our core area of the business, but it's certainly a service that members need and that they would like us, they want us to provide, and that's what we are doing. As far as the international credit reports are concerned on specific businesses worldwide, they're always freshly investigated. We do not offer database reports. And this is, again, based on the input we've gotten from our members. When you do business outside of the U.S., or if you're in Europe outside of your own country, things do change, and they can change very quickly. So information can be stale if it's from a database, and that is why we have made the decision to provide only freshly investigated credit reports. And what we've done, it's an enormous amount of work, but we have managed to do it by vetting and establishing relationships with the best local sources of credit information worldwide. And that enables us to provide what we think is the highest quality, freshly investigated, and most competitively priced credit reports for our members and for non-members as well, like I said. The best part, perhaps, is there are no contracts required. So all you can do is take advantage of the ICTF knowledge of world markets and the powerful connections which we have. We've done the work for you, at least the groundwork, and give us the information. We'll provide the report to you. Virtual global credit networks, which are, I'm not going to spend much time talking about that, but this is another membership benefit, and this is provided, we are able to offer this because of the relationship we have with our platinum sponsor, Credit2B. These are wonderful global credit networks where people can upload their portfolio and gain access to the portfolios and the trade experience of everyone else in their industry worldwide. So it's a very robust system, and it works well, and not everyone is using it, but some members, those who are involved, they find it quite valuable. So that's, in a nutshell, the resources and the benefits, the membership benefits, which are available to those who choose to belong to ICTF.
Wow, that's, Aneta, you can really talk, you know that? can really get on your horse, and you're off and running.
That was good, honestly.
we have to take a quick break. I do want to talk again when we get back. I want to talk some more about the credit reports, the international credit reports. You kind of zipped through that, and I kind of missed part of it, and I want to slow down and go over that a little bit more, because credit reports, obviously, for a credit person, well, what can I say? Am I right, Rick? You got to have credit reports if you're going to make credit decisions on customers, and I'm very interested to find out what you said and how you do your credit reports, but that's all when we come back, folks, so stick around. We have Aneta Spilman from the ICTF talking to us about international credit and collections, and we have Rick Balgobin, my real good friend from Denver, Colorado, as my co-host. Stick around. Don't go anywhere.
Do you ever think back to the very first day that you opened your small business? And that warm and fuzzy feeling that you had that your future was so bright that you had to wear shades? Phil Philbin here for CCMA Consulting Services. Soon that shine wore off, though, and you came to the conclusion sooner or later that perhaps you just might not know everything you need to know. That's where CCMA Consulting Services can help you in your business bring back that warm sunshine feeling. Our services provide world-class B2B credit and collection management nationwide. Feel free to call us at 815-765-1589 or visit us online at ccma-llc.com for more information about our nationwide network of consulting programs and associates. After all, at CCMA, credit is what we know. It's all we do. I'm Phil Philbin for CCMA, and we'll keep the phone lines open for you.
Hi, this is Jody Owens, and I'm the education team leader for CMA. We offer a variety of training and educational programs specific for credit and collections professionals. CMA offers in-person and online training, from one-hour webinars to 10-week classes, and everything in between. Call us for a free recorded webinar of your choice. Call 888-889-7913, extension 222. And don't forget, education is the key to your success.
Thank you. We're back live on Business Credit Radio. We have as our featured guest today, Aneta Spilman from the ICTF. And we also have my friend Rick Balgobin from the My High City in Denver, Colorado as a co-host. Thank you. This is a great conversation. I love this. And like I say, boy, Aneta, can you really talk? At any rate, I want to talk to you a little bit more about the international credit reports that you offer in your resource sections on your website. Can you go into that a little bit more again, please?
Sure, I will be happy to do that, and perhaps I just glanced through that and moved on because, like I said, we are not a commercial credit reporting agency per se. What we do is provide a service to our members who want us to take care of that. They don't want to be bothered. They don't want to have to go through signing a huge contract and not knowing what to do with it. They want to be able to call and to have a person who is dedicated to the credit reporting service, and who will help them to get the best possible credit report. They've left the vetting to us. They've left the establishing of these relationships to us. And what we are able to do is simply pass the savings on to the members, taking advantage of the volume of credit reports, the combined volume, which we end up ordering from the various local providers of credit reports. But most importantly, I think the vetting and our ability to take care of the report, to make sure that the quality of the report is as good as it gets and to make sure that the turnaround time is what it's supposed to be. So we are constantly monitoring that. We are monitoring the supplier. We are monitoring, like I said, the quality and the turnaround time, and these are probably the most important factors. I will say, and I will be very honest with you, reports differ. Everyone who's involved in international business and even in domestic business knows. But on the international side, it becomes even more convoluted because because of the transparency of credit information, because of the various financial requirements, the financial reporting requirements in the market. So if there are many cases, unfortunately, where you will not get financial information on a customer located somewhere around the world, I would say perhaps just a ballpark number, 70% of the credit reports which we provide do include financial information, but about 30% don't. And that is simply because companies are not required to do that, and in some cases, the lack of cooperation, which I always tell our members, and they're the ones who share the same information among them, that sometimes that is an indication of something. We're not going to arrive to a conclusion what it means, but in many cases, the lack of information and, as you well know, the lack of perhaps trust and the buyer who is not willing to provide any financial information. Yes, we do check. We do check all the legal records. We do check for bankruptcies. We do check other suppliers and how they're selling and how they're being paid and all that. But sometimes there are enough red flags in the lack of information which help the credit professional make a better credit decision. And that decision, maybe I'm not suggesting anything here, but it may be no credit extended or less amount of credit, or we definitely need to get involved with our export credit insurer and see what can be done so we can mitigate the risk. We can assess the risk and we can figure out how to mitigate it. So that's just one small portion of the credit decision making, but a very valuable service which we're able to provide to the members. And like I said, the good part is that
let me help me walk down this path here, because I still am not sure I am understanding. Mm-hmm. I have a new customer, okay?
Mm-hmm.
He's in Dusseldorf, Germany, of all places.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And I need to find out about this guy. It's a new company, and I mm-hmm. come to you and say, okay, I need a credit report. How does the whole process start, and what do mm-hmm. I get? And go from there, please.
Okay, very easy. All you need to do is come to us, tell us that you need a report, give us the full contact information of the company. The more information we have, the better, and decide how fast you need the report. It could be a standard report, which costs the least amount of money. It could be express or super rush. If it's a new customer and there is an order and the salesperson is pushing and it needs to be released in the next 3 days, and you have to make a decision for international one, for Western Europe, Germany, you would probably order super rush report, which is the most expensive one. But if we're talking about ongoing relationship monitoring, or you have more time for making decision-making process, you can take advantage of the standard speed, which is significantly less expensive. And just to give you an example, for Western Europe, anywhere in Western Europe, the standard speed report costs $90. So what we do, we have the information. We go to our local supplier, who is we consider the best in Germany. We order the report. We make sure it's the right quality. We make sure it comes in on time or sooner, preferably. We review everything and we send it on to you, and you are done, ready to make your credit decision.
A pretty good idea. Do you use other external sources of information? How do you actually put together the report? I mean, do you use grading, for example, and maybe an international DMV? How does all the information come to you to be able to put together a report to give to me?
We don't use Graydon or DMB to answer your question, but we use local credit reporting agencies, the ones whom we consider to be the best in a specific market. So we are reselling the information and we're passing the savings on to the members. instead of a member trying to figure out that, okay, I need to have a worldwide contract signed with company X for my credit reporting needs, they don't do that. They don't want to have a contract for $100,000 signed up front with one company. They want to come to us and to go, depending on the country, we will order the report from various, like I said, local credit reporting agencies whom we have vetted and whom we consider to be the best in a particular market. There are many other resellers of credit reports out there. We prefer to go to the source, to establish relationship with the source, which allows us to better monitor the turnaround time and the quality for the benefit of the members. Does this make sense?
Wow, yeah, it does. That's completely different from, like you say, subscription type of purchases of bulk number of credit reports like you would through DMV and other sources. That's an interesting concept. Rick, do you have any comments on that?
That is pretty new. I mean, this is the first time I'm hearing about it, and I think it's something phenomenal that credit managers who, like ourselves, who don't have who have to handle international accounts, this is a good resource to use.
Not only that, think about it. $90 a report, please.
And it's just $90, and they can get it done to you, expedited to you within a couple of days, and your management team can make decisions on these, plus other resources that they have given. So that's great.
It works very well. It works well,
impressive.
And that's why members like it. Because you can order one report, you can order 100, 10, 50, doesn't matter, whatever your needs are. And as you know, they do fluctuate depending on how the business cycles and risk and monitoring policies, procedures. So you don't need to worry about a contract and units and how many you will use, how many you will not use, none of that. Like I said, it's not for us a big part of the business, but it's certainly a very important one for those who would like to use us. Now, I will say there are many members who do have the huge contracts with various credit reporting agencies, because in addition to the credit reporting, perhaps they have some other monitoring facilities and systems on the domestic side. And we are not the source of credit reports for them. But again, it's available, and those who use it are extremely pleased with the service and with the quality and just how easy it is to provide the credit report, and it takes the hassle out of them. It's just we do the work for you. That's what we're here. Anything we can do to help and make your job easier and your life easier, we are more than happy to do it.
Well, this has been a great show, very enlightening for me. I'm very happy to have an association with the ICTF and Aneta once again. Rick, do you have any final questions before we go, or is it getting a little late?
First, I must say thank you very much, Aneta, for taking time out from your busy schedule and joining us. And on behalf of Phil and CCMA and Blog Talk Radio, I would certainly like to extend an invitation to you to come back on board, because we have so much to ask of you. And looking at what your organization has done in 3 years, kudos to you and all the best. And I'm glad that we are affiliated or associated with your organization.
Oh, thank you. Thank you for the opportunity. I'm so delighted. And anything you need, anything we can help with, please know that you can count on us, not just you, but also everyone out there who is listening or who will be listening to this Internet show. It's like I said, ICTF is a terrific organization. And if you are involved, if your company is involved with international business, it is a must-join organization. Like I said, I'm biased, but also very passionate and very dedicated to serving the needs of the international credit professionals, and we love it. We enjoy every single minute of it.
Thank you, Aneta. It has been a great show. And for our listeners, one more time, Aneta, tell them how they can get in touch with ICTF.
Yes, our website is www.ictfworld.org, and I will also give you my telephone number. You are more than welcome to contact me at any time. We are located in the U.S. on the East Coast in Baltimore, very close to Washington, D.C., and I would say the credit insurance capital of the U.S., both Euler Hermes and Atradius are located in Baltimore. So the telephone number is 410-522-5013. This is how you can reach me, and my email address will probably be posted online. It is Aneta, A-N-E-T-A, dot Spilman, which is S-P-I-L-M-A-N, at ictfworld.org. So I look forward to hearing from you if you have any questions or any needs or anything we can help with. Please stay in touch and enjoy the rest of the day.
Well, thank you, Aneta, and thank you to all of our peers and credit management and finance management professionals worldwide for joining us once again on Business Credit Radio. And, of course, we have to thank our sponsor.
This evening's show is partially brought to you by the Credit Management Association, a proud affiliate of the National Association of Credit Management that has helped business-to-business companies with their credit, collections, and financial decisions since 1883. Contact CMA at www.creditmanagementassociation.org for more details on how CMA can benefit you.
Thank you once again, everybody. Rick, thank you. Aneta, thank you. And we will see you again. This is Business Credit Radio. We are the voice for credit and collection management.